morning, everyone. Firstly, I apologize for my French accent. I am a PhD student in the University of Toulouse. My research is about a late Iron Age habitat identified in the current area of Toulouse. It concentrates mainly on the relationships between domestic and specialized or activity space. In this session, I will present a case study that we put into question Iron Age settlement pattern and ways of dealing with them. In the current area of Toulouse, archaeology revealed two main centers of late Iron Age occupation, Vieille Toulouse and Saint-Roch. They are separated by 5 kilometers away, the one from the other. Both are characterized by a high density of archaeological remains. Ancient texts refer to a city named Tolosa, which was the main agglomeration of the Valkyrie Tectosagi. It's a Gallic tribe evoked for events going as far back as the 200th century BC. Much ink was spilled on debating which one of the two sites, Vieille Toulouse and Saint-Roch, could be identified with the capital Tolosa. The question of the statue of this settlement and the nature of the relationships has been heavily discussed and led to the formulation of several hypotheses. Two phases can be at the outline. The first one corresponds to the pre-Roman period that begins at the end of the 3rd century BC. This phase is characterized by two large main centers, by farms and specialized areas. The second phase starts toward 100 BC. It is characterized by the persistence of farms and the only one main settlement, Vieille Toulouse, while in Saint-Roch, only few traces of occupation persist. This restructuration probably is a consequence of Roman intervention in 106 BC during the war against the Cimbri and the Teuton. Indeed, textual evidence refers to a Tectosage king fighting alongside the invader, captured by the Roman army onto the further sacks of the city sanctuary by the Roman. This defeat means for the Volcae Tectosage a loss of their political autonomy and status of ally to Rome. As we could see, settlement in the region of Toulouse evolve from the complex towards the more simple, with two main settlements observed during the first period, while the structure of the second phase may be considered more classic with only one center. For the first phase, the most widespread hypotheses provided to explain this complex settlement pattern are the following. A model of political and symbolic domination of Vieille Toulouse over Saint-Roch. With an elite presence at Vieille Toulouse, Vieille Toulouse is the oppidum and the capital of the Valkyrie Tectosage, while Saint-Roch is only an area of activity dependent of Vieille Toulouse. Over hypothesis, several agglomerations coexist, but the main center is located in Saint-Roch because of his economic predominance explained by its topographical position. In this model, the economic and politic domination is exercised by Saint-Roch over Vieille Toulouse. Sorry, I have a problem. From a topographical point of view, these two settlements are very different. Saint-Roch is a lowland settlement, while Vieille Toulouse is a hilltop settlement, position which ensures a natural defensive position. Both settlements are very close to the Garonne River, the proximity permitted exchange towards the Atlantic. Both sites are not equally now from an archaeological point of view. All rescue excavation have permitted the discovery of 100 water wells each site. These wells give us a general vision of the extent of occupation. These are the main and almost the only structure preserved, with the exception of a few pits and post holes. However, they reflect very indirectly reality because the material found in it is clearly not in situ. A study of their content nevertheless revealed a considerable amount of vestige of domestic construction and specialized activity all period together. The area excavated from the beginning of the 21st century as part of preventive archaeology rely on urban development projects allow for the first time to characterize domestic building. Most of the construction was based on local material such as mold and wood. To address issues related with the possible hierarchy or complementary of these both sites, I have concentrated on the spatial distribution of activity markers. During the first phase, material related to domestic work, such as mining, weaving, and spinning, or material linked to the domestic life, like dishes, show that domestic activity are spread over the entire extension of both sites. In some areas, domestic and specialized space are intimately linked in the urban map, as you can see in yellow to Saint Roch and blue for Vieille Toulouse. However, at Saint Roch, in some places, an organization by area of activity appears. During the second phase, the situation not differ really from the one that will be observed. A forge is set up toward 80 BC in Vieille Toulouse within the habitat. We can suppose blacksmiths lived and worked in the same place. This proximity reveals a certain permeability of the activities between domestic and craft sphere. From 75 BC, a specialized area with pottery kilns develops on the margin of the habitat. On the site near of Ancoli, not directly linked to the two main areas of occupation, pottery kilns now for the first period. It may be assumed that this activity is moving and is annexed to Vieille Toulouse in the second period. During this second phase, we can observe that this process of polarization of domestic and specialized activity observed in the first period continues. However, we can see emergencies of handicraft districts at Vieille Toulouse. Another criteria important is trade. Reused as construction material after wine consumption, amphoric furniture is found in large quantity on all sites in Toulouse, demonstrating the importance of Tolosa in trade and consumption of Mediterranean products. The dishes of importation are also well represented, in particular the one of Italian tradition, but also of Iberian ceramic and gray ceramic of the Catalan coast. These two types of material are present on both sites and faces. It can be observed that areas which concentrate most of the imported dishes are reduced. These areas are also the ones that have delivered the most dense number of domestic remains. The material culture reflects the diversity of geographical origins of the inhabitants and exogenous culinary practices. It informs as much on the relation that textosage maintained with the neighbor, as with the possibility of Iberian inhabitants at Veitouz and Saint Roch. No difference appear between the both sites from this point of view. Another feature common to both sites is the presence of a rare artifact in southern Gaul, styluses, used for writing and accounting. This finding substantiates that volcanic tossage were the center of a large network of trade, but also of information. Styluses are present in both periods. The distribution map of Iberian imported dishes and styluses are quite similar. Maybe it reflects area occupied by trader, maybe. Finally, I concentrated on the structuration of spaces. During the first phase, urbanism on both sites remained initially quite fluid. However, after the 140 BC at Veitouz, a regular urbanization plan materialized by ditches and streets, defining housing blocks have been identified. The orientation of this structure will continue during the second period, despite the historical context at the end of the second century. To conclude, categorization is a constant preoccupation of scholars. The Mediterranean conception of a town with a single center is too present in our mind. We must consider otherwise the case of Toulouse. At the first phase, the extension of atypical organization leads to wonder about a hierarchy or a division of function, political, economic, religious, between two settlements. I believe that the question of scale of observation is crucial. Indeed, by observing the volcanic tectosagi capital from afar, we have a feeling of a main center of occupation with Tolosa, the capital, concentrating all the functions like you can see on the map. But the center is organized according to a polynuclear pattern which seem to work like some sort of polycentric entity, sort of central nucleus, with several centers of occupation geographically separated but linked by the interconnection of their function rather than a single central place. The second phase is more classic, with a kind of reorganization closer to the Mediterranean model, with political, economic, and cultural center as a Roman sense.